Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to Wednesday morning. My name is Stephen Whiteside from theuptrend.com with today's look at North American stock market trends. In the pre-market this morning, we're getting a little bounce in the futures. Dow futures currently up 99 points. While commodities are mixed, crude oil is slightly higher, while gold is lower on Wednesday morning. Let's start off looking at the fear index, or the VIX. The VIX closed higher yesterday, had an inside day or a day of indecision, so looking for a breakout of the previous day's range on Wednesday. We need to close below 2450. Of course, if that doesn't happen on Wednesday, that lower channel line is going to continue to move higher daily. Once again, it was all about those big cap technology stocks that everybody used to love. Apparently, they don't love them this week. There's the Qs moving lower yesterday. In the pre-market this morning, we're up nearly 3.5 points. We were down nearly 14 points on Tuesday, so not that big of a recovery on Wednesday morning. Of course, if you have new sell signals, you can use Wednesday morning to sell into strength. But there's the Spider Technology ETF making a new low for this move, as did the semiconductors, as did the software ETF. Looking at the energy sector, we see the Spider Energy ETF making a new low. Equipment was lower, exploration was lower, so no joy for the energy sector. And of course, that is a big factor in the Canadian market. General Motors spiked higher yesterday. You haven't seen that in a while. Making a new high for this move, so making a deal with a battery company, and that is helping General Motors, which of course a lot of people have walked away from over the past few years, but it was one of the bright spots on Tuesday. Let's walk through those technology stocks everybody's following. Inside day for Apple yesterday, inside day for Amazon, no change in trend, of course, newer low for Facebook on this move. Then we saw Google make a new low for Microsoft, inside day or day of indecision for Netflix, day of indecision for Shopify on both sides of the border, then an inside day for Square, and a new low for Tesla and Zoom. Zoom had a very quiet trading day yesterday compared to what happened in the rest of the technology sector. On Wednesday, we're looking for a close below 333.93 to give us a sell signal. And you can see that that lower channel line is right just above the top of the bottom of the open gap. So we could potentially get a bounce off that number right there. So just keep an eye on that. Of course, if you own Zoom, you should have taken money off the table by now and sitting with just a partial position left. Moving over to the Canadian market, we got a head start on the selling. The Canadian market started to sell off a couple of days before the U.S. market did. So we made a new low for this move yesterday, looking at the iShares for the TSX 60. There's the iShares for the energy sector starting to break down below the July lows. Then we see financials. Financials actually closed slightly higher than they opened, so not any panic selling in the financial sector. Gold stock still on a sell signal here, treading water. We traded up to the upper channel line yesterday on the iShares for the gold sector. We need to close above 2390 to give us a new buy signal on Wednesday. Taking a look at the most actively traded Canadian stocks from Tuesday's trading action, we won't find any new trend changes here. We saw Suncor make a new low. We saw big selling in CNQ. Then we've got a new low for this move for Manulife. No change in trend for Enbridge, closing above where it opened yesterday. Then we had an inside day for BCE, still on a sell signal. No change in trend for Bank of Nova Scotia. Then we've got Barrick treading water here, trading above and below the channel lines yesterday, closing up near the upper channel line. And so a close above 38.88 would give us a buy signal for Barrick on Wednesday. No change in trend for Air Canada. We've hit 18.75. So if you had an order in to get filled there, it got filled. Then we're looking at Bank of Montreal making a new low for this move. Then we're looking at Kinross, still on a sell signal, no change in trend. That would change on Wednesday with a close above 11.65. Okay, folks, that is all for Wednesday morning's presentation. Looking at the futures, they're continuing to move higher this morning. Dow futures currently up 140 points. So we are looking for some buying at the open on Wednesday morning. Of course, if you've been waiting to sell, selling at the open on Wednesday morning would be a good idea. Have a great day, folks, and the next time you'll hear my voice is on Thursday morning, and once again, we'll take a look at the North American stock markets.